the South African jungle, the celebrities certainly ate a lot of beans. They actually didn't have a choice and they didn't enjoy it much. But does this protein-powered superfood really live up to its reputation?
Wasn't me. On earth was...
Farts will never not be funny, really. You are about to find out which way the wind is blowing. Dr. Beau Miles is an adventurer and lecturer in outdoor education at Monash University, and he's decided to study the effects of a diet of beans by eating absolutely nothing else until he's consumed his own body weight in those nutritious little nuggets. And he joins us from Melbourne. Thank God for that. Because I had the Glen 20 ready just in case. You never know what might come out of you. What made you want to do this, Beau? What a strange thing to do.
Well, I've got a few props with me, and the first one is John Steinbeck's tortilla flat. And so there's about 10 lines in this where a school teacher finds out that her school kids only eat beans. And so she sends around the doctor to the house, and lo and behold, the doctor finds these super healthy kids and all they eat is beans. In fact, the grandmother just ladles them straight out of the pot onto the floorboards, and the kids have got to eat them off the floor. And I'm going through a Steinbeck phase, as I suppose hipsters do in their 30s, you know. And so I thought, how do I recreate that as an adult? And can I be this healthy nut brown kid in an adult form? So that's what started it off. And then there's all sorts of other layers I've added to it.
That is the best reason for doing anything I have ever heard. Yeah. How many cans? You said you're going to eat your whole body weight in beans. So how many cans does that mean a day? And how far are you along now? How many days are we talking?
Well, there's tin 103. Oh. And I've taken I've got about five varieties and I've taken all the labels off to give myself a... you know, spice of life, so I'm not sure what's in it. So it's 103, and I thought it was going to be 160 tins based on the old 500-gram tin.
Yeah.
Mm. But no, I've got a big Excel spreadsheet going, and I noticed that I wasn't getting as close to my halfway point as I thought. So it's actually about 200 tins of beans, so I'm just over halfway.
You think you're Dr. Mosley, that English doctor who keeps doing crazy things. So what is it you're trying to prove?
And just what sort of beans are they? Are they baked beans? Well, kidney beans?
Oh, yeah, they're baked beans, I assume. You said five different varieties?
Yeah, no, I've got a baked bean stock standard, which are the most Australian beans I could find. Mm-hmm. And then the other half are black beans, white beans, pinto beans, navy beans, garbanzo beans, Mexican beans. And
at least you're getting variety.
Well, yeah.
You're like the...
Oh, well, there was one day, completely randomly, it was just all black bean. And at the end of the day, I thought, this is ridiculous. I needed to plant something a little bit more sexy in the mix. But I forget your question, which is probably poignant, because I think for every kilo I lose, I've lost about 4 kilos.
Really?
I've actually...
Now we're interested.
Now we're really...
How long have you been doing this diet for, did you say?
This is day 23. And I'm categorically getting dumber and humourless. So
grumpy. And thinner, which makes you really good for TV.
Well, yeah. Yeah, they said that out there, yeah, in the lobby. They were saying, well, you look good, Beau. You must be eating beans only.
What other side effects have you got? I mean, without getting too graphic, but get as graphic as you feel. Are you bloated all the time? Has it affected your health in any other way? Are you're an endurance athlete? Is it affecting your athletic performance?
Well, whilst I'm a doctor of philosophy, I'm not really an expert in anything other than maybe myself, as we all are. So I'm just trying to really shake up my sort of felt response to the world. So everything I do now is through beans. The rods in my eyes, my nerves in my fingertips, everything is driven by the calories, energy, minerals in beans. And so I'm really fascinated by that. And as a runner, I know you are too, Joe.
Yep.
You know, I've completely plateaued my running, and in fact, it's really shaken up what I think I can do with my body, because I'm essentially on about an 8% carbohydrate diet right now. You can't do much at all.
Wow.
Yeah, right.
Now the windy thing. Look, I'm a windy bloke anyway, so my wife's the best gauge of it, and she's saying I've certainly increased it, but it's not drastic.
Do you heat them up?
Wow.
Do you heat
she hasn't kicked you out of bed yet.
Isn't that...
No, I'm not a bedwinder anyway. I just think that's the height of rudeness.
Oh, good man.
Well brought up.
I like
man,
it. Man, thank you.
We all need to re-engage in our lives. has it affected your social life at all? Are you allowed to have a beer with your beans or...?
No, there's no alcohol. My only sort of get out of card is tea. I have tea with a dollop of milk. Caffeine withdrawals for the first couple of days were horrendous.
Yep.
It was total headache. DT stuff. Mm. Oh, epic. And so that was the hardest part. Then I went through this real clean period where I thought, wow, this is wonderful. And for the last sort of week, I've been a grumpy bum and I don't know. I'm questioning everything. Beau, what are you doing? You know, because I'm making a film about this for my YouTube channel, and I'm trying to bring out a narrative, and I'm not sure what it is other than just eating a lot of beans. And I've got to bring some. Oh no, that sounds ridiculous. And so that's what I'm saying to myself. What's the story, man? You know, so I've got to really dig deeper, and
maybe
I'll be doing that
nothing.
The next few weeks.
Yeah,
maybe
just go with just it. Don't question
there's
it.
There's no
just
story.
Yeah.
The physiological thing is, you know, everyone loves diets, so we read a diet based on advice. And it's a very two-dimensional piece of information when someone says, you should eat X, Y, Z. I want to eat beans on my own devices and really pull apart how I'm feeling and what I'm capable of. Mm. Because once I return to the full supermarket spread of foods, I have a better understanding of me versus food, and I think that's one of the ideas.
Let's hope your next diet isn't based on Steinbeck's other great novel of Mice and Men. That could be.
Yeah, well, what would happen there? I'd die after a sort of a intrepid barn event or
indeed.
Something.
Well,
yeah.
I'm currently working my way through the Grapes of Wrath, which
indeed.
Is basically just a bottle of wine a night.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Well, yes. I haven't had alcohol for a while too, and I tell you, I'm keen.
Dr. Beau Miles, you are a champion. Thank you so much for talking to us this morning.
Thanks,
and good luck with your mission.
Thanks, team.